This episode exposes a serious threat to our financial system. The risk is enormous.
Many retail investors woke up on January 28th to find that they could no longer buy and sell stocks the same way they could the days prior, and they were being treated differently than other market participants who could still buy and sell those same stocks.
On January 28th, our daily deposit requirement was 10 times more than on January 25th. Meant that Robinhood Securities, our clearing broker, had to host additional firm capital. As a result, Robinhood Securities imposed temporary trading restrictions on certain securities.
But when I go to Robinhood's website and the blog post you initially released on January 28th, your financial requirements with your clearinghouse are not mentioned. You only mention market volatility. And when I review the Robinhood customer agreement, you don't include specifics on how and when you may decide to restrict trading, which you did. And you don't include any language or disclosures regarding your capital requirements. It only includes vague language that at any time and in its sole discretion, Robinhood can restrict trading.
For a period of time, some of your users could only sell and not buy, and that could have contributed to the stock actually going because some of your users were prohibited from buying.
We began allowing limited buys of these securities the following day, and we have since lifted the restrictions entirely.
In other words, you seem to reserve the right to make up the rules as you go along.
Look, I'm sorry for what happened. I apologize. And I'm not going to say that Robinhood did everything perfect and that we haven't made mistakes in the past. And Robinhood as an organization will learn from this and improve to make sure it doesn't happen again. And I'll make sure of that. So this event was a Five Sigma event, which is a 1 in 3.5 million event. To put that in context, there have only been tens of thousands of stock market days in the history of the U.S. stock market. So a 1 in 3.5 million event basically is unmodelable. That said, we can learn from it. And in this particular case, our risk management processes worked appropriately to keep us in compliance with all of our deposit requirements and collateral requirements. And that additional capital, the $3.4 billion, wasn't to service our requirements. It was entirely to prepare for a future, even greater Black Swan event and to unrestrict and remove restrictions on the trading and buying of these securities.
Well, I expect we will experience future events with increased volatility, and Robinhood's recent actions appeared arbitrary, which is why I don't blame customers for feeling treated unfairly. Your trading restrictions came out of the blue and your communication was not clear.
Stepping in to prevent trading where a stock price moves contrary to conventional wisdom could deprive the market of important information.
Letting existing regulations work is key, not burdening everyday investors with new and more costly barriers to entry.
Robinhood Securities put the restrictions in place in an effort to meet increased regulatory deposit requirements.
And yet, on January 28th, you represented to the media that there was no liquidity problem. Isn't it true that being concerned about having enough capital to meet deposit requirements, isn't that a liquidity problem? Or could you just answer yes or no?
Chairwoman Waters, I appreciate the opportunity to address that.
Just yes or no?
We always felt comfortable with our liquidity and the additional capital that Robinhood raised.
Please answer yes or no.
We always felt comfortable
with our liquidity. I don't have time. I just need a yes or no answer.
The additional capital we raised wasn't to meet.
I'm reclaiming my time. This liquidity problem had real consequences for your customers, but I wonder if they were all that surprised.
The temporary volatility in these stocks did not present a systemic risk to market function. The market's mechanisms generally work well to handle these circumstances.
During the period of frenzied retail equities trading, Citadel Securities was able to provide continuous liquidity every minute of every trading day. We're able to...
Noah, are you here and what are you doing?
Excuse me?
That wasn't either one of us. Continue, Mr. Griffin.
All right. So Citadel Securities...